What's up internet, I'm Manish from RebellionRider.com and I'm back once again with the third tutorial in the user privilege series. Till so far we have seen introduction to user privileges and a detailed tutorial on system privileges. And today in this SQL tutorial we will learn about object privileges. The links for my previous two tutorials of user privileges series are in the description box in case you haven't watched them. So let's start today's tutorial. As I have explained in my introduction video that object privileges allow user to perform certain action on database objects, for example executing DML on tables. Every database object has a particular set of object privileges associated with it. The most commonly used object privileges are select, insert, update, delete and execute. So without further ado, let's jump into the tutorial and do some query. If you remember, in the previous tutorial we granted create table privilege to user Hulk and Batman. Which means both these users can create a table, but what if they want to access the data from the tables which are owned by some other user? For example, say user Hulk wants to select some data from employees table which is owned by HR user. Let's try. For this, I will use my command prompt. And now I will connect to my database using user Hulk. Let me show you the user. As you can see, the user is Hulk means I am connected to my database using this user. Now I will try to select the data from employees table which is owned by HR user. As you can see, we get an error here. This is because user Hulk doesn't have any privileges which allow him to perform select DML on employees table owned by HR user. So to solve this problem, we will grant select object privilege to user Hulk. For that, first I will connect to my database using sysuser and now I will use my SQL developer. And here is my sys connection. And now I'm connected to my database using my sysuser. Let me show you the user. As you can see, the user is sys. Now I will grant the select object privilege to user Hulk. Our statement starts with grant keyword followed by the name of object privilege which is select in our case. After that, we will write on, which is again a keyword followed by the database object name. In our case, employees table is the database object that belongs to the user HR. This relationship between user and the database object can be shown by supplying a prefix HR, which is our username, followed by a dot that denotes the link between employees table and the user HR. After that, we again have another keyword too, followed by the username Hulk to which we are granting this object privilege. Let's execute this grant statement. Grant succeeded. And now let's try to again select some data from HR table using user Hulk. Means we will again execute our select statement here. This one. And as you can see, we just retrieved 107 rows from our HR table using the user Hulk. Okay, let's move on to second query. On database object tables, apart from select object privilege, we can also grant update, insert, delete, index, and references object privileges. To grant these privileges, we can either write separate grant statements for granting individual privilege or we can club all the privileges in a single grant statement, such as or you can replace this list of object privileges by all keyword. For example, let's execute these statements. Grant succeeded. Both these statements are same and perform the same task. Now user Hulk has all the privileges on employees table. Isn't it simple? Okay, now let's move on our third query. Oracle allows you to grant object privileges on column level also. But you can only grant insert, update and references object privileges on column level. Say you want to grant update object privilege only on first name column of employees table, then for that the query will be. Let me make some space so that you people can see things clearly. And let's close this script output. Okay, everything is set now. So let's write the query. On executing this query, user Hulk will be able to update only the first name column of the employees table. Let's execute. Grant succeeded. Similarly, you can grant insert and references object privileges also. Okay, now let's move on to the next query and see how to use with grant option. Just like we use admin option flag with system privileges, similarly we use grant option flag with object privileges. Grant option flag allows the user to grant an object privilege to another user. Let's see how. Let's grant update privilege on employees table of user HR to user Hulk with grant option this time. Let's again close this script output. And now let's write our fourth query. After executing this query, user Hulk not only gets the update object privilege but can also grant and revoke the same privilege to and from any user or roles. Let's execute. Grant succeeded. Now I will connect to my database using user Hulk and then grant this update privilege to the user Batman, just to demonstrate this with grant option flag. For that I will again use my command prompt. And I guess I'm already connected to my database using user Hulk. Let's check. Yes, the user is Hulk. Let me clear this command prompt screen so that you people can see what I'm going to write next. Okay, everything is set now. Now I will try to grant the update privilege on employees table which is owned by HR using this user Hulk to user Batman. For that, we will again write the grant DCL statement. If you want, you can also add the with grant option flag here. Let's execute. Here we go. Grant succeeded. I have done this blog on my website. For the detailed knowledge of the concept, you can read this blog and the link is in the description box. That's it for today, guys. Hope you enjoyed watching. Hit the thumbs up. If you like this video, you can also comment your feedbacks and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon. Till then, take care. This is Manish.